Hello guys, we are going to discuss about GPS system, global positioning system. So what is global positioning system? You might have used in your mobile phone Google Maps. So in Google Maps, whenever you are going somewhere, your blue dot will follow there. So wherever blue dot is going on there, that means your mobile phone is particular place. Based on that blue point, you can assume that okay, I am here at particular crossroads or I am at particular place. So how exactly this GPS device will work? So what is the criteria? Have you wondered that for GPS working, is it internet necessary? No. As our GPS device, which is in the mobile phone, will communicate with the satellites, so it does not require any internet connection. So if you want to locate your position on particular Google Maps, so internet is required. So to get the latitude longitude value, you does not require any internet connection. But to display your latitude longitude value on particular Google Maps, you need internet connection. So if you can download Google Maps in offline mode, if you have no signal of 2G, 3G, 4G, and if you not have 4G connection or data connection also, you can use the Google Maps. Internet is not required, but your Google Maps should be downloaded in offline mode, and your GPS device in mobile phone will work by communicating with the satellites without any internet connection. Okay, so here we are going to discuss about GPS device, how it would work, how it will communicate with the satellites, and how GPS device will determine the particular place and height of particular GPS device from the above mean sea level, and time of particular place and speed of particular GPS device. Okay, we are going to follow this. Start. Hello everybody, myself Suresh. I am going to explain about GPS concepts here. So we are going to discuss about GPS concepts. GPS. What is GPS? Global positioning system. Global positioning system. Global positioning system. All of you familiar with the Google Maps, and we are using Google Maps whenever we want to travel somewhere or whenever we want to reach some destination without knowing the routes. So how GPS is working in our mobiles and how exactly GPS is working in Google Maps. So I am here going to explain about Google Maps and GPS. So here, global positioning system, it is a system developed for the navigation by the US States Department. It is owned by the United States Space Force. So all the GPS system is managed by the US government, and we are following GPS of Navistar system. Navistar system, it has been launched by the US government in 1978, and it is being operated by the United States Space Force. So we are following GPS of United States. What exactly GPS determines? So we need to have a GPS receiver, so which is our mobile phone, or it can be our GPS device. So GPS device detects the location of latitude longitude, that is place which consists of latitude and longitude, and it determines the height from the mean sea level, height from the mean sea level, and it can also determine the time. So if it is not a mobile, if it is a GPS receiver and we want to know the exact time at that particular place, it can be determined by the GPS receiver. And it can also track the speed. It can also track the speed. So in our GPS device, we are going to detect the latitude longitude value and the height and the time and the speed. How this GPS receiver will determine that? So GPS receiver does not require any data connection. Does not require any
data connection. It can simply receive the signal from the satellites and it will determine us the place and the height, time and the speed. How it can determine the latitude, longitude value, height and time and speed? I will explain to you. United States Department has launched about 33 satellites for the GPS system. Now 31 satellites are in operation. Total 33 has been launched and 31 are in operation, and they have promised us that they have promised all over that any time 24 satellites will be in working condition. So at any time 24 satellites will be in working condition. So these 24 satellites has been divided into 6 parts, that is 6 into 4 constellations. 6 into 4 constellations. Each constellation consists of 4 satellites. Each constellation consists of 4 satellites. So these 24 satellites are in the 8 GHz range. MEO range, medium Earth orbit. So that is 20,000 kilometer above the Earth. 20,000 kilometer above the Earth. So here, let us imagine it is the Earth, and there will be 24 satellites for one constellation, and another constellation, another constellation, another constellation and another constellation. So it would be another constellation. There will be 6 into 4 constellation, means there will be 6 poles and 4 satellites in every constellation. Means 1, 2, 3, 4. So each constellation consists of 4 satellites. At any point on the Earth will receive the signal from the 4 satellites. At any point on the Earth, so will receive the signal from the one constellation at any time. So each satellite will revolve around the Earth. So this is the satellite. So this satellite will be around above the 20,000 kilometers from the Earth, right? And this orbital, this will revolve around the Earth about 2 times in a day. That is 2 times in a day, means it will cover every point 2 times a day. 2 times in a day. So this is about satellites which are in the space. So there will be 24 satellites, 6 pods, each consists of 4 satellites, and each satellite will revolve around the Earth 2 times a day. So this is about satellites in the Earth, satellites in the sky. So there will be 24 satellites in the sky. So how our GPS will determine? How our GPS will determine the exact latitude, longitude and the height of a particular position? So let us say you are in somewhere in the forest or somewhere in the earth, somewhere on the earth. So this is the place where you are located, and you should determine the latitude, longitude of particular place and height of the place and the time at particular time and the speed of your GPS receiver. So at any time, up to now we have covered about, so GPS has 3 stations: at space and ground monitoring, and 3 receiver, that is GPS receiver. GPS receiver. So in the space we have 24 satellites and 6 constellations. So each constellation will have 4 satellites. Each constellation will have 4 satellites. So each satellite will revolve around the Earth 2 times a day. 2 times a day. That is, orbital period is 12 hours. 12 hours. So at any time, our GPS receiver will in contact with the one of the constellation, which we have 6 pods, 6 constellations, and each constellation consists of 4 satellites. 4 satellites. At any point of time, our GPS receiver will get the signal from the any one of the pods, that is from the 4 satellites. So at any time, our GPS receiver will get the signal from the satellites. So our ground monitoring system will monitor the satellites, its atomic clocks and its pods. Our GPS receiver will receive the signal from the satellite. It will receive the signal and it will process the data using our DSP process. Then it will tell us the particular place and the height and the particular time at the particular place and the speed of our GPS receiver. So how it will determine the exact path and how it will determine the height of the particular GPS receiver. So as I said, every GPS receiver, we are somewhere on the Earth and our GPS receiver is getting signal from the one of the pod, it is getting signal and our GPS receiver will receive the signal and it will tell us the location used on the triangulation method. Don't confuse with the triangular method. Triangular method is used to find out the angle. Triangular method is used to find out the angle of particular point. Angle of the particular point. But in triangulation method, we are going to find out the particular point distance. As we know, signal will be received from the first satellite and the second satellite, third satellite and the fourth satellite. So when we receive signal from the 4 satellites, so using the triangulation method we can determine the precise location of particular GPS receiver. So we are going to discuss about triangulation method. The triangulation method, let us say from first satellite we are getting a signal and it is covering particular area, and from the second satellite we are getting the signal and we are covering particular area, and again from the third satellite we are getting the signal and again we are getting covering for particular area. So again from the fourth satellite we are covering another area. So where we are getting particular point, so it is the precise location of particular GPS device. It is the precise point of particular GPS device. We are getting one area covered by first satellite and second satellite, and this is from the third satellite and this is from the fourth satellite. From these 4 satellites we have been covered this particular spherical area and this would be the particular point. So based on the distance from the satellite, we know already how much distance this satellite would be, and we know how much distance it would be, and we know how much distance from the 4th satellite and how much distance from the 3rd satellite. So based on the distance we have already known and we have covered particular area, and based on the calculations we can get particular point latitude and longitude and height from the mean sea level, height from the mean sea level, and we are getting time. As atomic clocks are already installed in the satellites, so whenever it is downlinking the signal, it will send the particular time to the GPS receiver. So we are also getting time, and based on the velocity of particular GPS device, we can also determine the speed using our DPS algorithm in the GPS device.